Tesla is going totally berserk, increasing the range of all their car models, while even reducing the price of the Model S. So why suddenly this new pricing strategy? Might it have something to do with the pricing revelation of the entry model Lucid Air? And of course, we have to give you the latest update on Tesla Gigafactory construction all around the world.
And was? The Germans cut off the water supply from Giga Berlin? Then Waymo is opening its driverless service to the public in Phoenix, and Volocopter's air taxi will take part in air rescue field testing. And then we'd like to talk about a company which aims to build cheap and powerful molten salt nuclear reactors, which could provide lots of clean and cheap energy. A lot to talk about as always, so stay tuned.
Okay, it's time to spread FUD again. FUD, standing for fear, uncertainty, and doubt. This is what the idiotic mainstream news media has been doing with Tesla since day one, and they're trying it time and time again. This time, because Tesla has been lowering the prices of their cars. Yeah, certainly. Tesla just had the best quarter in their entire history, despite a giant global pandemic. If anyone has declining sales, it's all other car makers. And Tesla is actually the only one with rising sales. Really the only one worldwide. Anyways, the pricing of the base Model S has been reduced from $71,990 to $69,420. $69,420 being a quite funny number. This is of course not a coincidence, because Lucid just unveiled the starting price of the Lucid Air, which is now priced to start at $69,900 after a $7,500 federal tax credit. The Tesla Model S starting price is, by the way, before incentives. The stats of both cars are really comparable. The base Model S coming in at 402 miles of EPA rated range. The base Lucid Air coming in with 406 miles of projected range. Intonation on projected. We have to say that we really like the Lucid Air, and it's indeed the first worthy challenger of the Tesla Model S ever. But the Tesla Model S still has a giant advantage. Namely, you can buy it right now. Like, really right now. But for the Lucid Air, you still have to wait until spring 2021. And you know that Lucid has not yet started mass production of the Air, so delays are possible. But still, we have to say that it's quite impressive of Lucid to basically make Elon drop the price of the Model S.
Much to our dismay, by the way, because with that pricing we could have bought a Model S for the price which we paid for our Model 3 Performance when we bought it 1.5 years ago. We of course were overzealous and bought the Model 3 when it came to Germany, but now the Model S is so cheap that with the added German EV incentives, we'd have a Model S for a lower price. It's a bit brutal, but that's life. If one buys Tesla, one must know that we are still early adopters, and by buying a Tesla now, you help future Tesla owners to get cheaper Teslas, thereby you actually help mainstream electric car adoption, and you are doing a good deed for humanity. Anyways, Tesla's pricing strategy shows how insanely flexible they are with their prices. Tesla is continuously dropping prices of all its models. The Model 3 Standard Range Plus, for example, is now not so far away anymore from the famous $35,000 price which Elon said the Model 3 would start at back in 2016. The Model Y starts at $49,990 and the Model X starts at $79,990. Because Tesla has the best profit margins in the whole electric car sector, since they were the first ones to closely cooperate with battery manufacturers such as Panasonic with in-house battery production, and are now even starting to build their own batteries, and are just continuously innovating on every front, thus they can reduce their prices at will and still make good profit. This is very, very different from other car makers who have very low profit margins, if they have profit margins at all, on their electric cars. Thus, Tesla can react flexibly with their pricing to any potential challenger, such as now happened with the Lucid Air, which gives Tesla an insane advantage over its competition. We are very sure that Lucid can't just drop the price of their cars randomly, because they just don't have the volume production yet, and also not Tesla's profit margins.
And please consider subscribing to our channel, because we are probably the only ones on YouTube who regularly do news updates on both electric cars and spaceflight. We know that's a bit weird, but we are interested in both. So thank you very much for your support. Tesla is also continuing to increase the range of all their cars. The Tesla Model X now got a range increase from 351 miles to 371 miles. And the Model X Performance even more, from 305 to 341 miles. Just like that. The Model 3 also got a range increase, with the long range version now reaching 353 miles. Which is quite an insane range for a price of $46,990. And the Model 3 Performance now stands at 315 miles of range. This was achieved by using a new heating pump, thus making the Tesla Model 3 more energy efficient. And it now even comes with Chrome Delete, a new center console, and freaking cool looking Überturbine wheels. Of course, the Model Y also received a slight range increase, and the Model S Performance received the most impressive increase. It's all nicely summarized on this table here by Rob Mauer at Tesla Daily. So yes, Tesla really has the highest flexibility and continues to improve their electric cars while making them cheaper at the same time. This is freaking awesome. Still on the topic of Tesla, we know that Giga Shanghai is finished, so nothing to report there. We are basically all just waiting for Model Y production to ramp up. It's only a matter of weeks now. At Giga Texas, or Tera Texas, in the latest drone shot from Joel Techmeyer. Thanks as always for these amazing shots, Joel. We can see that they have actually already started to dig out holes for the pillars, while some holes have already been filled with concrete, and steel frame construction has even begun. Amazing. Also beautiful how we can see the outline and the massive size of the future factory in this shot here.
Tobias Lind meanwhile shows us in his latest awesome drone video, thanks a lot Tobias for these amazing shots as always, how fast Giga Berlin continues to grow. We don't even know what to say anymore. The progress is crazy fast. But suddenly the Germans say, "Halt Tesla, you work too fast. We don't like that in Germany, and you haven't paid your water bills. That's why we will now cut you off from the water." Or that's what the good old mainstream news media would want us to believe. That evil Tesla just doesn't pay their water bills. This is what supposedly happened last week on Thursday. The news media, of course, were printing one headline stupider than the other, when in fact an accounting error had caused the problem, and not Tesla being evil and not wanting to pay their bills. Anyways, this shows again the brutal deterioration of the mainstream news media. It just keeps getting worse and worse. In other news, Waymo has now opened their self-driving car service in Phoenix, Arizona, to the general public. Waymo has a fleet of self-driving Chrysler Pacificas, which use LiDAR to scan their surroundings. While this is certainly impressive, we should not forget that these cars can only drive in areas that have been mapped before. So you couldn't just take one of these cars and let it drive, for example, in New York City. Very much in contrast to the Tesla Robotaxi service, where Elon said that the full self-driving beta will be rolled out to select testers this week. Tesla's Robotaxi service will probably brutally disrupt Waymo, but still, we think it's nonetheless cool to be able to drive around in Phoenix without driver.
Meanwhile, Volocopter, a German air taxi company, has conducted a feasibility study, which came to the conclusion that the Volocopter air taxi would be ideal to be used as an emergency air rescue vehicle. The focus of the study by Charitable Air Rescue Service, ADAC Luftrettung, and sponsored by the non-profit ADAC Foundation, was to determine if rescue services could be improved by using multi-copters to quickly transport emergency doctors in rescue scenarios. Though intended to work alongside existing fleets of air rescue helicopters, electric multi-rotor flyers could lead to more efficient use of helicopters in the future. They could, for example, be used to transport emergency doctors for on-site treatment in the majority of cases, while helicopters could be reserved for patient transport and only deployed if needed. Real operational testing of the Volocopter air taxi for such a scenario is now set to start in Germany in 2023.
Now to something completely different. You know that we often talk about renewable energy on this channel because we think that fossil fuels are really not the best idea. And transitioning to sustainable transport in the form of electric cars and renewable energy in the form of solar and wind are really good ideas. Because emitting gigantic amounts of CO2 into the atmosphere might be, you know, a bit dangerous and might lead to some unwanted or unforeseen side effects which might be difficult to control in the future. We even talked about fusion reactors sometimes, which will also enable us to create giant amounts of energy. But what we mentioned only once in an earlier video, this one here, are molten salt reactors. In that video we explained how molten salt reactors work. The short version is that instead of water as a coolant, here you have a molten salt that takes over the role of coolant and also acts as fuel. And the cool thing is, it would act as a fission source, thereby self-regulating itself, and thus a dangerous water overheating and explosion could not occur. Of course, there are still quite a few design challenges to overcome until we can have mainstream molten salt reactors. For example, the corrosivity of hot salts is a problem, and the changing chemical composition of the salt as it is transmuted by reactor radiation.
Nonetheless, the company Elysium Industries is working on a molten chloride salt fast reactor, short MCSFR. So what is so cool about this type of reactor? Well, it can consume spent nuclear waste and weapons waste and then transform it into useful energy. The reactor can create up to 1200 megawatts of usable electric power, which is not bad, considering that MCSFR would leave no radioactive waste products. Nay, in fact, it would clean up the waste of standard design nuclear reactors. Molten salt reactors should get more love, especially Elysium's design, because nuclear is not instantly evil, as some would want us to believe. MCSFR reactors could become a viable additional energy source in the near future, while at the same time ridding us of nuclear waste.
So we can see that Tesla is expanding like crazy, and they might actually even build a Gigafactory in India, about which we talked in this video here.
And don't forget our first ever live stream on Sunday. You can get all your questions answered.
So thanks as always for watching the JS Disruption Report. And then I would say, on to the future.